Good afternoon, this is Patty. Anyways, I am putting the tops on the cupcakes, which are called Yellow Mums. And I started with a little dollop in the middle. I shouldn't say a little one, but anyways. So, what I'm going to do is I'm using this tip right here. I don't know if you can get a good picture of it. But you start out on the edge. And all you're going to do, I don't know. Let me get started for you. Okay, you're kind of leaning down and then you are pulling up. And it doesn't look like very much, but once you fill it all in, let me see if I can get this one's a little bit higher. But once you fill it in, it looks very good. So, very easy, and I'm no cake decorator. But I made my soap, and I wait for the right consistency. I'm going to have to use both hands. You just kind of lay it down and pull it up. And it's easy if you have a turntable, even if it was littler than this. Can you see? I can't get any closer. And I don't have my help, that's for sure. And in nature, these petals are not perfect. So if the Lord designed it to be like that, then I guess we can mimic it with soap. Just don't worry about that bottom layer. Okay. See, don't worry about it. Because you're going to be going in and you're going to fill it in. And it will look beautiful. And you want to try to go in between if possible, but like I said, the flowers in real life are now I'm just trying to go up and down mostly, but I want that little curl on it. And you get these layers on there, and then you just go back and fill it in as you go, and as I'm talking, I get louder and louder. Trying to get this done. My husband's coming home for the weekend, but he knows I'm doing this. Try not to, as I told you before, while he's at home, unless he's doing something, and I can do something pretty quick. And then you're going to get to that mound, and then you're just going to work on that mound all the way up, and that gives it the height. I think I might have to back over just a couple of them that I've already done and get it up there. But see what I'm talking about? You're getting right to the middle part. I just know, as clumsy as I am, I'm going to drop one of these when I bring it in. And just keep going around. And then when you get all this filled in, then you just go back, and if it's leaning a little bit, or if it gets kind of long-legged, which I never had a problem with that, I've always been short-legged, but just kind of pop it down. Now, if this hillbilly can do this soap piping and figure out a way to get it to work, I know that anyone can. And I go straight up. Now, you see how that is on the side? I want to fill them in, so I just go back over it. Should clean my tip. Whoops, what am I doing? Sometimes I'm not talented to be able to talk while I'm doing something. I get sidetracked. I am so glad that I froze a couple of dinners. Of course, Flynn, my husband, always knows that, so when he comes off the road, he says, can we have this for supper, or is it a busy day? Don't we have such and such in the freezer? And I'm always thankful, especially when he comes home on Friday. You never know exactly when he will be in, but today he's going to be here early, so he says, so we already have supper already planned out. Okay, I think it looks like a mum. Maybe I should get a little bit more on this, up on the top. That's the nice thing about it, if you got something that's workable. But you are the creator, so. And the nice thing about piping is it's very relaxing, unless, like last night, I had a fast-moving soap. And so I said, the heck with it, put it in a bag, and I said, I will do this in the morning and make just a 1 pound batch. But no soap goes to waste. Just cut it up, make new soap. It's ready for the sprinkles. So, oops. It's probably my husband. And if you want to go just a little bit more heavier than you usually do on the glitter, because part of it will fall off. So, you don't want that. You want to have some kind of glitter, because it's usually for a gift or a person. Alrighty, well,
I have all this to do. And like I said, I can't walk and chew gum, I guess. So, I will end this video. And hope you like it. If you got any questions, if you try to be perfect, that's when it seems like you make all your mistakes. So I know some of us out there are perfectionists. I'm not. I am a free bird, always have been. I always try to improve, but I don't get discouraged. I just say, well, next time I think I'm going to try, you know, this way. I have two daughters, though, that are perfectionists, so then they don't get nothing done. And we laugh about it because if it's not perfect, they give up. So don't give up, I guess that's what I'm trying to say. So I will quit my yakking and get the rest of these done. And I hope this helps. You have a good, blessed day. And please pray for the people in Texas and Louisiana. It's still not over with. And they're just really, really struggling. All right. Bye-bye.